Marc-Andre Fleury gets the start tonight. He is 1-4-1 in his last six. Four goals against or more in four of those games. Down to the other end, it's 32-year-old Victor Foss, who has started four of the last six, 3-1 over that span, but he is still looking for his first win here on home ice. Take a picture of the referees, Dan O'Halloran and Graham Skilliter. Brad Pansich and Mark Wheeler will be your linesmen tonight. Sidney Crosby played just his fourth game in Edmonton. His last game, January 10th of 2014. He does not come here very often, so the fans will be treated to the rare sighting tonight at Aero Pack Arena, playing just his sixth NHL game. 17 goals to Miners, one of the top goal scorers in the AHL, inserted on the top line in the absence of Taylor Hall and Benoit Pouliot out of the lineup tonight for the Oilers. Center ice, here's the new jump to Jordan Everly. One little move, he's in. Everly shoots it. Fleury makes the stop on the hot stick of Jordan Everly. He's got three goals in his last few games here. Two the other night. Still no hat trick in his career, though. Now we're about Christian Ehrhoff back there. Blake Como still out. Hopes to be back soon. Pouliot first to the puck. Saw the head coming, got it away. Now it's picked up on the fly by Downey. Downey down the left side, stops up, looking for help. Steve Downey with a shot at the skate, centers it out in front for Spaulding, and his tip just went wide. Back to line, this is Max Lapierre. Off of the end board, swept by Downey. Downey trying to dance away from Schultz in traffic, back end in front again, trying to find Spaulding. And here is Pouliot. Pouliot, one move, throws it in front, nobody holds the Penguins. Zach still carries it in. I'm going to ask you about that in a second here. As he goes back to the line, Scuderi towards the net, kicked aside by Fost into the corner. Pressure out in front. Look out, turnover. Fost bails them out with a glove save after that pass was thrown right out in front of their own net.
That's another big save at a critical time.
Here's Kunitz now. Kunitz looking for Perreault. Turns and fires a shot just wide. Boy, would he love to get one here tonight. Here's Crosby now. Crosby with a puck in his stick. Turns, shoots, bounces under Bertuzzo. He fires one, and that's blocked off the stick of Barron.
And that Gordon line did a nice job of defending and then pushing the puck back up the other way.
Seconds tick away. Goes off the stick of Kunitz, and that will be it. So the Edmonton Oilers, outshot 10-5, as you say, they will take this. Victor Foss, solid in the opening 20. Marc-Andre Fleury, not quite as busy in a scoreless game here. Not a lot of defensive play in the All-Star game.
How about the pace of that one?
How about
that looks
none?
Like a men's league game. Unbelievable.
Highest scoring All-Star game in NHL history. So, play is underway here in the second period. The Pittsburgh Penguins had just 21 shots on goal in their last loss. A season low against Nashville at home ice. They're halfway to that total already. And there's a loose puck right in front. Foss is down. They score. Rebound. Batted in with Foss scrambling to find that puck. And in the opening minutes here, the second period, the Penguins strike first.
Now, boy, seemingly all under control. Victor Fash with a bit of a funny bounce. And instead ends up in the back of the net.
And here they come again. Perreault with a shot and a save made by Foss. The assist going there to Letang and Arcabello. And now Foss is down. A collision with Perreault, his former teammate.
Victor Foss wants the penalty here, and Perreault's coming over to talk to him. A bit of an errant play and a bit of an overplay by Foss. He's yelling at him and saying, that's my side of the net. You ran right into me. The officials were right there, and no arm went up. Dan O'Halloran is having a discussion.
Everly goes back to the line, moved across to Fane. Fane shot blocked right in front by Hornqvist. Up to Malkin, who's got the game's only goal. Chris Letang drops it off for Malkin. Back across. Hornqvist couldn't get a shot away. Second attempt. Foss is down with that pad. And the puck goes in behind the net. Victor Foss is the reason this game is not 4 or 5-0. Hornqvist. Stripped of the puck, and it's back to center. Here comes Neil Yakupov. Into the forecheck. And it put back in, and it just missed. What a chance for Roy. Pouliot has put up huge points for Mike Johnston with the Portland Winterhawks. Here's Malkin now to Arcabello. Good shot, a great save by Foss on the one-timer. Here is Pouliot again. Bouncing puck got away from him. Sail change for Todd Nelson. Yakupov with a rocket drive. And Fleury made a good stop on that hard shot by Neil Yakupov. He'll go across to Petrie. His pass hits the post. Rebound. Sharks are now 19-11 overall. The power play helping the Oilers get a little bit of momentum, but the Penguins come back in. It's Archibald with Hornquist. Archibald in, five to save. Puck is loose. Malkin bottles up, and now it's Dupre turns and shoots. Foss makes that save. Great action around the Oilers there, and they skate it away. Victor Foss, what a performance he's putting on tonight. A gut call by Todd Nelson, and he is answering the call for Edmonton. Back at the center, Letang with some room moving across to Crosby. Mishandled the puck, and the Oilers get it out. Paul Martin checks the clock, throws it up the ice. David Perron steps in, time for one last shot. Here's Letang, leans into it, Foss scores! Just as time expires, they're calling it a goal on the ice. There are zeros on the clock on that shot from the point, which was tipped right in front, and they're going to take a look at this.
My live reaction was that there was some time left, and this is a rolling puck that Sidney Crosby delivers to Chris Letang, and Letang just unloads on it. Another great example of the importance of going to the net, David Perron, no time on the clock. A rolling puck that is a hard one for Victor Fast, and there's no kicking motion there. Off the right shin pad, off the left shin pad, and the clock ticking far too slowly for the Edmonton Oilers as it goes in with .5.
And they were almost out of it, down 1-0 through 40 minutes, but instead, with half a second to go, the former Oiler gets one.
And coaches talk all the time about going to the gritty areas, and this is just payoff for being there, and there's no question what this is going to be called.
On video review, the puck entered the net with 0.4 seconds left on the time, and it was deflected to net. No distinct kicking motions. Good goal.
And it ends up in the back of the Oiler net.
And instead of a one-goal game, it's a two-goal deficit. Well, it's working. Thank you, Elliot. That is seven goals in this, his 13th game with the Pittsburgh Penguins, Greg.
I don't think there's any question that his game has sped up since going to the Penguins. I think one of the issues playing with Leon Draisaitl early was that line as a group stopped skating. Did a lot of standing still, and when you get with Crosby, you're forced to get to another level.
Into the corner goes Yakupov. In there against Dupre, who wins that puck battle. Out in front of his own net, and Fleury will save. A good blocker stop of a dangerous pass in front of the Pittsburgh net. And Fleury bailed his base out, but they're still buzzing around him. Back towards the net, that shot goes wide. Ferris waits for it. Took a look to his right, goes back into the corner. Here's Roy. Try to send it out in front, that goes off the skate of Malkin. Roy back with it. Late man coming in. Petrie in there. Fleury steps up and makes a stop.
Here's the shift that you're looking for. The possession shift in the offensive zone. Good cycle down low and a couple of great saves by Fleury.
Fleury wander put his head. They try to swipe it out in front and just couldn't get it in there as the Penguins send it back in with 3.5 to go.
And Hendricks is going after David Perron, and now is not the time.
Right in front of the Oilers bench, Bortuzzo comes in and throws a punch at Matt Hendricks. These two teams both will fight a lot.
At times you get a sense of what teammates were really like when they played together, and Hendricks didn't hesitate going after Perron there, and Bortuzzo jumped into his aid.
Some edge to the game as we go down the stretch with 3:23. This is Nelson's second unit power play. Out of the corner comes Roy, goes back down low. Fraser with a quick tip, and Fleury with a good stop on Matt Fraser. Net is empty, and Crosby's got the puck, gets to center ice, takes a look, and look at that block by Schultz to keep the game alive. 1:07 to go, and here comes Klefbom. His shot blocked right in front of him by Dupre. Faceoff goes into the corner. Just out of the reach of Martin. Martin pushing up the boards. Nugent Hopkins down low. Yakupov down in front. There's a chance for Roy. Couldn't get the shot away. Sent down the ice, and that will do it. As Petrie looks at the clock, and the Pittsburgh Penguins win 2-0 with the seventh shutout of the season for Marc-Andre Fleury. And the Penguins kick off their three-game Western Canadian road trip with a nice little two-pointer.
Mike Johnson looking for a reboot. He got it. A good energy game by the Penguins.
Three stars for the Knights as Fleury gets congratulations all around here on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey. 35th shutout of Marc-Andre Fleury's career. As mentioned, he leads the league now with 7. Already did with 6. Jeff Petrie had a solid night for the Oilers, star number 2. And Chris Letang, who had another assist to add to his already impressive total.